Here's a comparison of chickens. Each comes from different time periods. Unselected strains from the 50s, the 70s, and a commercial Ross 308 strain from 2005. All are the same age and fed on the same diet, but their weights vary greatly, from a paltry 900 grams to more than 4,000 grams. A 2014 study found out that the growth rate of broiler chickens, the chicken raised for meat, has increased by some 400% from the last 50 years. We have been eating more chickens than ever before in human history. Worldwide, more than 114 million tons of chicken meat were produced in 2018. And meat production is expected to rise concurrent with the human population growth, so it makes sense for chickens to grow bigger. But behind the intended beneficial changes achieved by the chickens lie serious matters of concern. Heavy commercial selection pressure towards faster-growing broilers has produced the desired prolific yield, more than quadrupling the chicken's body weight in just 50 years. This tremendous size increase isn't achieved by the use of hormones or steroids, rather by selective breeding and higher density feed. In 1945, ANP organized the first of its Chicken of Tomorrow contest, and with it marks the beginning of the effort to genetically improve commercial broiler production. Broiler breeders have been selecting chickens for decades. Over the years, market forces and other factors have changed the selection criteria and made selection objectives more complex. Better selection tools like the BLUP allows breeders to evaluate how traits relate to one another and develop chicken strains suitable to meet the market demand. Continuous picking over the preferred traits, rapid early growth, heavier yield, and more efficient feed conversion ratio, that is the ratio measuring the efficiency of livestock to convert animal feed into products, in the case of broilers, meat, have driven the gradual yet directed change, leading to the creation of the common broiler strains of today. But despite the apparent increase in individual bird weight, the number of birds slaughtered for meat each year hasn't slowed down. Rather the opposite. Some 69 billion chickens were slaughtered in 2018, a tenfold increase from the past 50 years. Global production of poultry meat has risen by a whopping 1,300% since 1961. And in the past 20 years, meat production has increased by nearly 60%, driven by the population and income growth. In absolute terms, meat production is rising, but the demands of a meat type have changed, shifting towards poultry. In 1961, poultry accounted for only 12% of global meat production. By 2018, its share tripled. In the US, chicken consumption per person rose from 28 pounds in 1960 to 97 pounds in 2020. And this soaring demand has taken a toll on the chickens. Intensive farming has posed billions of birds to welfare concerns. Broilers are kept at high stocking densities. Most rearing sheds exceeds the recommended threshold. Overcrowding restricts chickens from performing their natural behavior and leads to increased heat and humidity, dirtier litter, and fecal contamination. This makes bacterial infections such as dermatitis common, affecting up to 48% of chickens in some flocks. Poor ventilation in the sheds leads to high concentrations of ammonia and dust in the air, which irritates the broilers' eyes and respiratory tracts, increasing their susceptibility to infectious diseases, including the Newcastle disease. Antibiotics have been used to suppress broiler deaths caused by bacterial infections. Antibiotics prove to be an ideal and cost-effective way of increasing poultry production. Chickens grow faster and get sick less often. The poultry industry uses a lot of antibiotics in feed additives, two times as much as the cattle industry. Extensive usage of antibiotics promotes the release of the drug into the environment, leading to residue, and subsequently to the emergence of antibiotic-resistant bacteria. But even then, there are deaths and diseases unpreventable by excessive antibiotics feeding. Millions of fast-growing broilers die in their sheds from heart failure, and billions more suffer from lameness. The use of high-density feed has made metabolic disorders like the sudden death syndrome common. Affected birds die suddenly with short, terminal, wing-beating convulsion, often found flipped over onto their backs. And large numbers of broilers have impaired walking abilities with evidence of birds experiencing pain, discomfort, or inability to walk altogether. The diseases caused by abnormal leg bones development are attributed to the rapid weight gain. Leg disorders are a major cause of poor broiler welfare. Rapid growth rate has allowed broilers to be slaughtered young. They typically reach slaughter weight of 2 kg within 40 days of being hatched, half of what it would take 30 years ago. Broilers with this rapid growth rate are extremely inactive and have an increased motivation for eating, which predisposes them to organ failure. In fact, they have difficulty surviving into adulthood. Some that are groomed to be used for breeding purposes are severely restricted to their food and appear chronically hungry and stressed. Poor welfare continues up to the point of slaughter, such as improper handling. Evidence of violent struggling of shackled birds is common. Long overcrowded transport subjected chickens to thermal stress, suffocation and dehydration, and improper killing. To reduce the suffering experienced by the chickens, sufficient electric current must be used to stun, or preferably, kill the majority of the birds by inducing cardiac arrest. And next, both carotid arteries must be severed to ensure quick death from blood loss. When the requirements are ignored, birds are at risk of being conscious during neck cutting or regaining consciousness during bleeding out. Chickens are capable of experiencing pain just like cattle, but they have comparably less legal health and welfare protections than their mammalian livestock counterparts. Consequently, in most cases, they suffer from poorly regulated farming practices. The inflation-adjusted cost of producing a pound of live chicken dropped from more than $2 in 1934 to just 45 cents in 2004. But energy and feed costs remain high, and as the cost of land and other resources increase, it is likely that many commercially produced chickens will continue to be grown under less than ideal conditions for the foreseeable future. Stricter regulations regarding stocking densities, transport and waiting times at slaughterhouse, and slaughtering procedures are needed to improve broiler welfare. Ironically, the fast-growing broilers are an efficient meat producer. Contrary to the increasing weight, the amount of feed needed to produce the meat has been steadily declining. It takes 3.3 kilograms of feed to produce 1 kilogram of chicken meat. Scoring highest in efficiency of protein conversion and energy or caloric conversion, it is the best meat source when compared to other livestock resource-wise. Chicken is by no means eco-friendly, but it is considerably less resource-intensive. And poultries are non-ruminant, so they don't produce the highly potent greenhouse gas methane, thus having significantly lower direct carbon emissions than beef. But this efficiency has been achieved by intensive farming in industrial scale. Improving broiler welfare comes with the expense of the industry's production capacity. The environmental impacts associated with the poultry industry can be attributed to three main factors: feed production, energy use, and emissions from housing and manure management. Better alternatives such as free-range farming can improve the welfare of broilers by using slower-growing breeds and environmental enrichments to increase broiler activity. Painful leg disorders and heart problems can be significantly reduced. But slow-growing breeds are less efficient in producing meat. Longer rearing period requires more feed and produces more waste, thus increasing emissions. And the land required to rear chicken this way would be massive. An area about the size of Indonesia and Cambodia combined is needed to match today's production rate, not including the area needed to grow feed. The expansion of land for agriculture is the leading driver of deforestation. Today, 41% of all cereal crops are used as animal feed, 77% for soy. Industrial chicken farm largely relies on animal feed made from soybean. 37% of the global soy production is used to feed poultry. The integration of insect as animal feed in place of soybean can bring a significant improvement in reducing the environmental impacts of the poultry industry. Black soldier flies and common house flies often reside in manure piles and in organic wastes. Farming them, especially their larval form, could provide nutritious feed to livestock and at the same time promote better manure management. But there are challenges that make insect farming difficult to implement. Insect farming is a complex topic and requires a video of its own. The larger broilers might seem like an improvement in our abilities to produce more food more efficiently. Chicken has become an affordable delicacy and has provided animal protein on the plates of so many people. But these cheap meats come with ugly consequences. Farming chicken on a massive scale brings devastating impacts to the animal welfare. And regardless of the method we use to sustain such high production output, a substantial amount of suffering and environmental impact will be generated. The very same thing that allowed broilers to reach record-breaking weights has also made chicken meat production problematic. And these problems are being continuously fueled by our growing appetite for meat.